Recently, a friend, who shall remain unnamed, bought a 2TB USB flash drive. That got my attention. I thought maybe I just wasn't up to date about USB flash drives. Then I was told it cost just $5. Some of you might now be thinking, there's no way that's legit. I did a quick search and found that brands like SanDisk only make flash drives up to 1TB, and those cost $120. Anyway, let's take a look at the thing. This is actually the original packaging. It says USB cable. That really doesn't inspire confidence. There's a big HP logo in the front as well. I'm not sure I believe that. The device has both USB A and C ports. It even comes with an adapter to USB OTG. Well, it looks like a flash drive. Let's see if it actually works. I'm not in the habit of plugging random USB devices into my computer, so I'll be using this. Okay, we're in. Let's take a look at the disk manager. Sure enough, the flash drive is reporting a capacity of 2.1TB, so it's all good, right? Nope. The reported capacity can actually be faked. To find out what the actual capacity is, we need to write data to the drive, then read it back to verify that the disk actually stored the data. F3 is a great tool for this. It stands for Fight Flash Fraud. We can install it on Ubuntu using apt. Note the name of the device. Writing the full capacity of the drive could take absolutely ages, but since we're using Linux, we'll use F3 Probe. It writes less, but to different areas of the drive to estimate the true capacity. Alright, the tool's done. The total runtime was about 12 minutes. And what a surprise. The drive's a fake. The usable capacity is only 32GB instead of the reported 2TB.
It's not very good, is it?
In fact, F3 also reports that the drive is of type Limbo. Because the drive tells the computer that it has 2TB, you can actually try to write beyond its real 32GB capacity. When that happens, the new data will not be stored. It's kind of like filling a glass blindfolded. You don't know when the glass is full, so it overflows. F3 can help you prevent that. The f3fix tool creates a correctly sized partition, so you don't try to write too much data to the drive. However, if you can, it's better to just return the fake flash drive. We'll copy the recommended command into the terminal. And actually give it permissions. Once that's done, we'll see a new, correctly sized partition in the disk manager. The flash drive still reports its size as 2.1TB, but as long as you leave the free space unformatted, you should be fine. If you want to go down this route, I've put a link to the instructions in the description below. Now, why do I avoid plugging untrusted USB devices into my computer? You probably guessed it, it's a security risk. For example, a USB flash drive that appears harmless can actually reconfigure itself as something like a keyboard. As a keyboard, it can then deploy malware like ransomware and keyloggers. This is known as a bad USB attack, and it's just one of the many possible attacks a malicious USB device can perform. When it comes to flash storage, if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. It's not worth risking your data or security. Just get the legit stuff. I've had these for years and they have not let me down yet. For about $16, you can get a 3-pack of SanDisk 32GB USB flash drives. That's about $5 for each flash drive, which is the same price as a fake one. And it's USB 3.0, so you actually get decent speeds. If you really need terabytes of storage, get yourself a portable hard drive. I use a 5TB Western Digital portable hard drive to store my huge video files while traveling. If you need something faster, I can recommend getting a portable SSD. I use an Oracle M.2 SSD enclosure with a 2TB Crucial SSD. I've put affiliate links to all these products in the description below. All right, that's all. Subscribe and see you next time.